Okay, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave? Thank you.
Mr. Lee, Mr. Vaughn, and members of the school committee, faculty and staff, family and friends. On behalf of the class of 2018, I would like to welcome you to today's class day. We, the class of 2018, would like to thank you for your support and encouragement throughout the years. Today is a very special day for us. It's the beginning of new experiences, yet it is our time to pause and look back at what we have accomplished. I know that each of you have a reason to be proud. Thank you for sharing this day with us.
On behalf of this year's seniors, I present this key to the class of 2019. This key opens the door to future opportunities and responsibilities. The journey through your senior year is exciting and fleeting. Work hard and enjoy the fruits of your labor.
As the junior class president, I accept this key with confidence that we, the junior class, will strive to achieve the level of excellence that you have demonstrated to us over the past 4 years. Thank you.
We are going to read the dedications for the yearbook. Boom. When Thomas Jefferson sat down at his desk on a hot summer afternoon in 1776 to pen the Declaration of Independence, he must have felt a tremendous pressure. The nation was in turmoil, common folk were fighting hard in an intense, bloody rebellion against the tight-fisted control of Great Britain. They were unsatisfied and needed to know that change was on the way. Through his famous statement, Jefferson promised that this land was to be its own nation and that the written text making it so was to be dedicated to a new group of people, Americans. Megan Porter, likely impassioned by the heroic feats of this country's founders, found herself fascinated by the study of history. She graduated from Smith College, steeped in knowledge she was ready to share with the world. In 2014, she made her Lenox Memorial High School debut, teaching sophomores about European history. Her second class, now graduating this year, helped lay the foundation for Ms. Porter's general impression of the Lenox student body. As a member of this grade, I must say it was not great. We were intense, abrasive, immature, and demanding. We challenged authority, questioned the rules, and defied instruction. To many teachers, it was a relief when we stepped out of the school that one last time at the beginning of summer. However, instead of giving up hope, Ms. Porter stuck with us for another year, opting to teach us again for our junior year. Within us, she saw the tenacity of the founding fathers. She saw the rebels who fought hard against oppression, who stood up for what they believed in. Ms. Porter dedicates herself each day to teaching students about the past, knowing that that knowledge will always be relevant in the future. For her patience, kindness, and honesty, we, the class of 2018, dedicate this yearbook in her honor. For challenging our understanding, for allowing us to speak our minds, and for inspiring us to investigate further, we will always remember her. Now, as we feel the pressure of new independence, we thank Ms. Porter for her declaration to encourage us for 2 years straight, which, as she knows best, was not an easy task.
Ms. Porter.
No, she was actually stuck off campus for a while. She was
There she is.
At a certain point in Mrs. Pignatelli's career, she had a decision to make. She had had so much experience establishing herself as a leader in the field of nursing. She worked as a registered nurse at Berkshire Medical Center for over 20 years in several different capacities. She also taught the LPN program at Berkshire Community College. It was time for a new challenge, and what could be more challenging than working as the go-to medical guru in the Lenox school system? We are so lucky that she said yes. During the 8 years she had dispensed medicine and tissues and good advice, we have been on the receiving end of Mrs. Pignatelli's extraordinary kindness. When we were injured or sick, there she was with a warm, concerned smile and just the right prescription to make us feel better. When we needed a comforting, empathetic ear, there she was, available no matter what the problem or time of day. And then even greater fortune came our way when Mrs. Pignatelli joined our team and became our class advisor. At every step, she went beyond the call of duty to make our middle and high school experiences fulfilling and enjoyable. She became a guiding light and never hesitated to voice her pride in our accomplishments. Her love for Lenox and what she did extended beyond our school. She volunteered for the Lenox Board of Health, the Lenox Bullying Prevention and Intervention Community Task Force, our Safety and Wellness Task Force, and the Salvation Army Board. She also took great pride in her family as a devoted mom to Andrea, Mark, and Dan, and as a loving wife to her husband, Mr. Pignatelli. We miss you, Mrs. Pignatelli, and so we want to honor you. For your compassionate heart, healing hands, and beautiful nature, we dedicate our yearbook in your honor. We are so grateful for the time we had with you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm sure you might have noticed that there is one member of our administrative staff that is missing tonight. Mr. Kniebel asked me to pass on, especially to the class, the group behind us, that he really wished he could be here. He actually had a medical emergency last night, and the doctors told him he wasn't able to come today and possibly not tomorrow. We're hoping he's okay for Sunday, but he wanted me to pass on to everybody his congratulations to this group, and keep doing what you do. Well done. So we will start the award portion of our program today. Outstanding Effort Awards are given to those students who, throughout the year, have demonstrated consistent engagement and commitment to their academic improvement in a subject area. When I call your name, please come forward. In mathematics, Anna Lynch. In AP Physics, Andrew Conlin. In Anatomy and Physiology, Riley Burke. In AP Environmental Science, Noah Hofelder. In French, Peggy Yi. In Spanish, William Carroll. In Humanities, Ava Schiff. In computer-aided design technology, Andrew Conlin. In art, Brianna Hazel. In graphic design, Ava Schiff. In entrepreneurship, Bridget Collins. In exploring computer science, Adrian Williams. In marketing, Ava Schiff and Bridget Nicotra. In drama, Sean Coakley and Eric Mickle. We have 45 perfect attendance. Oh, no, that's not this group. Our perfect attendance awards are given to those students who have maintained perfect attendance during the school year. This year, our award goes to Isabel Conlon. In mid-March, all Latin students at LMMHS participated in the National Latin Exam. This is a very challenging test given at various levels to more than 150,000 Latin students from all 50 states and 20 foreign countries. We are proud to have two award winners from the senior class. In the Latin 4 poetry exam, magna cum laude, Kristen Parkinson. And silver, maximum cum laude, Noah Hofelder. The National Spanish Exam is the largest of its kind in the United States, with over 154,000 students participating, making this recognition extremely prestigious. The following student had received national recognition for having received greater than 80% on the national exam. This bronze medal was awarded to Adrian Williams. The Anne E. Mitchell Achievement Awards are given to outstanding seniors for commitment and determination in the study of world languages. This year's French Award is given to Kristen Parkinson. This year's Spanish Award is given to Alice Najimi. And this year's Latin awards are given to Noah Hofelder and Kristen Parkinson. The Nielsen Mathematics Award acknowledges the student who has demonstrated high achievement and deep understanding of complex mathematical concepts. The Nielsen Mathematics Award goes to Andrew Conlon. The Fermat Mathematics Award is given to a student who has shown outstanding achievement in mathematics. This year's award goes to Isabel Conlon. The Creative Writing Seminar has elected two outstanding seniors who have signified themselves in the written word. Please recognize Caitlin Aracy and Nicholas Montleone. The Expository Writing Award acknowledges a student who has demonstrated significant mastery in expository writing. This year's awards go to Amy Green and Bridget Nicotra. The Literary Analysis Book Award recognizes the student who has exhibited distinct writing proficiency in literary criticism and analysis. This year's award goes to Noah Hofelder. The James F. Hurley Humanities Award honors two seniors who have embraced the study of humanities and have shown remarkable intellectual and personal growth from this endeavor. This year, awards go to Gabby Toledo and Adrian Williams. The 21st Century Book Award, a teen publication sponsored by the Young Authors Foundation, is given to a senior who has shown outstanding achievement in the field of English. This year's award goes to Peggy Yee. The Coletta McCabe Holmes Award is given to the senior who has demonstrated outstanding contributions in the study of English. This year's award goes to Noah Kalisher-Coggins. The Joseph John Carroll Award is given to a senior who has demonstrated outstanding contributions in the field of humanities. This year's award is given to Isabel Conlin. The Michael Baxendall Award is named after the influential professor of European art history at California Berkeley from 1933 to 2008. This award is given to Anna Lynch for outstanding dedication to this field. The Natalie Zeman Davis European History Award is named after this European historian, pioneer in feminist studies, and the first woman president of the American Historical Society. This award goes to Alice Najimy for outstanding dedication to the study of history. The William Shakespeare Award is given to a senior for his outstanding contribution and dedication to our theater program, and demonstrated the principles for expression and creativity as exemplified by the world's foremost playwright and actor. This year's award goes to Evan Silverstein. The Award for Excellence in Musical Theater is given in recognition of outstanding contributions, leadership, and service to the musical theater program. This year's award goes to Peggy Yee. The Senior Internship Awards are given to students that have been working in year-long internships and have proven to be a valuable asset to that organization. This year, awards go to Nick Baruch, Harry Burns, Carly Dietz, Danielle Perry, and Tiana Thomas. The Scholar Athlete Awards are given to both female and male athletes who have shown continuous effort to excel in both athletics and academics. Each athlete must have a letter in at least two different sports, be in the top third of the class, be a good school citizen, and display good sportsmanship. This year's awards go to Alice Najimi and Noah Kalisher-Coggin. The 2018 Coach Ed Gilligan Award is presented to a senior female and male athlete on the basis of their sportsmanship, leadership, cooperation, and skill in more than one sport. This year, awards go to Jake Corcoran and Morgan Levesque. The Massachusetts Interscholastic Athletic Association is recognizing two seniors for serving as student ambassadors for the 2017-18 school year. This is an important role in our school as well as our community. Congratulations go to Noah Hunter and Alice Najimi. The Instrumentalist Magazine Musicianship Award is given in recognition of distinguished musical contribution. This year, awards go to Riley Burke, Isabella Conlon, and Anna Lynch. The Golden Hammer Award is presented to a senior whose outstanding work exemplifies the highest standards of the woodworking program at Lenox and whose skills and efforts have greatly contributed to the woodworking program here at LMMHS. Congratulations to Billy Carroll. At this time, we'd like to recognize those seniors who have served as class officers, members of student council, members of the National Honor Society, and the National Art Honor Society. Please hold your applause until all names have been read in each category. When your name is called, please stand and remain standing until all names are called. Class officers, President Noah Hofelder, Vice President Isabel Conlon, Treasurer Kristen Parkinson, and Secretary Andrew Conlon. Our senior members of the Student Council, Noah Hofelder, Casey Volley, and Peggy Yee. Senior members of the National Honor Society, Michael Abdallah, Caitlin Oracy, Riley Burke, Harry Burns, Sean Coakley, Andrew Conlon, Isabel Conlon, Jake Corcoran, Carly Dietz, Sarah Fenton, Brianna Hazel, Matthew Heim, Molly Herrick, Noah Hofelder, Alec Jordan, Noah Kalisher-Coggins, Morgan Levesque, Anna Lynch, Noah Mack, Nicholas Montleone, Alice Najimi, Kristen Parkinson, Ava Schiff, Evan Silverstein, Ryan Silverstein, Gabriella Suffish, Matthew Tibbetts, Gabby Toledo, Stephen Tran, Talia Traversa, Casey Volley, Adrian Williams, Brad Woodger, and Peggy Yee. Senior members of the National Art Honor Society include Caitlin Oracy, Riley Burke, Carly Dietz, Brianna Hazel, Molly Herrick, Cole Hodgkins, Ian Lauren, Morgan Levesque, Anna Lynch, Alice Najimi, Kristen Parkinson, Casey Valley, Adrian Williams, and Peggy Yee. Thank you all for your outstanding service to our school and community. Each year, the National Honor Society completes projects and donates service hours to our school as well as to the Lenox community as a whole. This year, the NHS completed over 2,050 hours of service. One student truly exemplified the concept of service to the school and community. The National Honor Society would like to honor Peggy Yee. The DAR Good Citizens Program is intended to encourage and reward the qualities of good citizenship. The student selected as the school's DAR Good Citizen must have the qualities of dependability, service, leadership, and patriotism to an outstanding degree. The faculty chose three seniors having these qualities, and from those three, the senior class selected one to be this year's DAR Good Citizen. This year's DAR award recipient is Peggy Yee. This year, our mock trial team went undefeated in the opening rounds of competition against Lee, Wakona, and Pittsfield. The team then competed in the regional playoffs against St. John's Preparatory at Clark University in Worcester. These incredible achievements were a result of a lot of hard work, hours of practice, and student leadership. In particular, this year's seniors took on significant roles in each trial that led to the team to their victories. If I could ask Noah Mack and Sarah Fenton to please stand. The high school quiz team completed its most successful year at Lenox in more than 10 years, winning the Berkshire County Quiz League. Noah Mack, the team's president, is a graduating senior. Thanks to Noah and the leadership of the other graduating seniors who participate in the quiz team, this activity is more popular and successful than ever. More than 40 high school students participated throughout the academic year. Congratulations to our senior members of the quiz team champions. Will the following seniors please stand to be recognized? Andrew Conlon, Isabel Conlon, Brianna Hazel, Noah Hofelder, Corey Jukacki, Noah Kalisher-Coggins, Anna Lynch, Noah Mack, Eric Mickle, Nick Montleone, Kristen Parkinson, Evan Silverstein, Ryan Silverstein, Talia Traversa, Stephen Tran, Casey Valley, Brad Woodger, and Peggy Yee. Each year, Lenox High School competes on As Schools Match Wits, the longest-running television high school quiz show. Nearly 50 schools from across New England compete in head-to-head matches. This past season, Lenox continued in its role as a quiz show powerhouse. For the fifth straight year, Lenox reached the final eight of As Schools Match Wits, this year finishing in the top four. Lenox also sent a select team to compete in Boston for a different high school quiz show, falling just short of the top 16 from among more than 100 elite schools in the Boston metropolitan area. All the members of Lenox High School quiz team were instrumental in our success in these events, but a nucleus of members prepared hard and performed admirably for these events. Will the following senior members involved in these select activities please stand? Noah Kalisher-Coggins, Anna Lynch, Noah Mack, Eric Mickle, Ryan Silverstein, and Brad Woodger. The High School Investment Club enjoyed another year under its president and graduating senior, Jake Corcoran. The club's young investors competed in a virtual stock market competition. While the S&P 500 was only up 0.5% during our competition, our two senior investors generated returns that Wall Street would envy. Would Noah Mack and Brad Woodger please stand? And congratulations to all in the Investment Club graduating seniors. The Stanley Z. Coplett Certificate of Mastery is awarded in recognition of a student's mastery of skill and knowledge in the fields of mathematics, science, arts, and humanities. Advanced and proficient scores on the grade 10 English language arts, mathematics, and science MCAS assessment initially qualify a student to apply for this certificate. The following students elected to apply for the certificate of mastery and receive tuition waivers to the University of Massachusetts or to any of the 7 state colleges or 15 community college. Please hold your applause to the last name is called as 75% of our students are recognized. Please stand when I call your name. Michael Abdallah, Caitlin Oracy, Reagan Bain, Riley Burke, Harry Burns, William Carroll, Lindsay Cass, Sean Coakley, Andrew Conlin, Isabel Conlin, Jake Corcoran, Carly Dietz, Noah Faravag, Sarah Fenton, Amy Green, Morgan Hayden, Brianna Hazel, Catherine Hedges, Matthew Heim, Molly Herrick, Noah Hofelder, Willard Hodgkins, Samuel Johnson, Alec Jordan, Noah Kalisher-Coggins, Ian Lauren, Anna Lynch, Noah Mack, Nicholas Montleone, Alice Najimi, Liam Newton Ireland, Kristen Parkinson, Danielle Perry, Christopher Schilling, Michaela Schneider, Ryan Silverstein, Evan Silverstein, Gabriella Suffish, Matthew Tibbetts, Stephen Tran, Casey Volley, Adrian Williams, Brad Woodger, and Peggy Yee. The John and Abigail Adams Scholarship provides a tuition waiver to the University of Massachusetts, the 7 state colleges, or 15 community colleges. This scholarship is limited to the top 25% of students in our school based on the grade 10 MCAS scores. The following students qualified for this scholarship. Please stand when I call your name and remain standing until all names are called. Harry Burns, Sean Coakley, Isabel Conlin, Jake Corcoran, Noah Faravag, Sarah Fenton, Brianna Hazel, Matthew Heim, Noah Hofelder, Willard Hodgkins, Noah Kalisher-Coggins, Noah Mack, Nick Montleone, Alice Najimi, Ryan Silverstein, Gabriella Suffish, Talia Traversa, Adrian Williams, and Peggy Yee. National Merit Commended students are among the top scorers nationwide on the preliminary SAT National Merit Scholarship Qualifying Test. A total of 34,000 students across the country from a group of over 1.5 million eligible students are recognized as commended students, placing these students in the top 3% of seniors in the United States. Congratulations to Matthew Heim. Matt, come on up. Noah Hofelder. Nicholas Montleone, and Peggy Yee. This year's Engineering Technology Award is given to a senior who has demonstrated exceptional aptitude and interest in engineering and robotics. He has been a leading member of the Lenox FTC robotics team for the past 3 years, helping his team earn berths in the Massachusetts State Championship competition 2 years in a row. He is hardworking, intuitive, creative, and possesses an intellectual maturity beyond his years. In the fall, he plans on studying mechanical engineering at Western New England University. This year's award goes to William Carroll. The Christina Labach Excellence in Science Award goes to a senior who has completed an extensive science education here in Lenox, plans on continuing their studies of science in college, and then takes their broad knowledge out into the world to change it for the better. Congratulations to Stephen Tran. The Physics Award is given to a senior who has shown great progress and proficiency in physics. This student draws on a vast fund of knowledge to provide a solid basis for taking on new challenges. Curiosity and creativity have been catalysts towards discovery. This year's award goes to Isabel Conlin. Richard Owen was a pioneering British anatomist with a remarkable ambition and determination to succeed. This year's Richard Owen Award for Excellence in Anatomy and Physiology is awarded to Alice Najimi for her remarkable work and dedication to the course. The Artistic Leadership Through Art Award acknowledges a student who has received a level of mastery through the principles and elements of design, visual reflections, skill, and technique in the visual arts. This year, two awards, one to Morgan Levesque, and Anna Lynch. The 2018 Art Award is given in recognition of outstanding skill in visual arts. Students selected for this award must demonstrate experimentation, persistence, sustained curiosity, and studio practice. Congratulations to Caitlin Aracy. The Advanced Placement Photography Award recognizes a senior for her enthusiasm, dedication, and devotion to the visual arts through the understanding and skill in articulating a coherent concentration and through a 48-piece advanced placement portfolio. Congratulations to Riley Burke. Our Photography Award. We would like to recognize Nick Montleone for his enthusiasm and exploration in the field of photography. Yeah! Nick has gained an understanding of the technical aspects of the camera and the process of traditional black and white photography, excels at producing thoughtful, personal responses and visual conclusions to every assignment. Congratulations, Nick. The Honorable Dennis Duffin, for whom our school's theater has been named, was instrumental in promoting the role of the arts in community, life, and learning. Therefore, it is only fitting that the Duffin Theater Arts Award be presented to a senior who whose commitment and technical accomplishments have helped make the theater become the superior performance space that it is. The 2018 Duffin Theater Arts Award goes to Lindsay Cadd. The Assistant Principals Award. These are given to seniors who demonstrate enthusiasm, energy, and vitality in promoting the Lenox School community through involvement in many different aspects of the school life. This year's award goes to two seniors for their constant contribution to making LMMHS a better place to be. First, Michael Abdallah. And Peggy Yee. The Massachusetts Secondary School Administrators Association Student Achievement Award. It's given to a student in recognition of outstanding contribution through a process of social influence, in which one person can enlist the aid and support of others in the accomplishment of a common task. Congratulations to Noah Hofelder. And I know Mike really wanted to be here for this one, but the Principal Award for Excellence, given to a senior who has demonstrated school spirit, community involvement, has high ethics and commitment to citizenship. Thank you, Casey Viley, for your dedication and contribution. Thank you. That concludes our awards portion, but if you could join me in congratulating all of our award recipients.
Students walk these hallways, counting the days until school ends. For the class of 2018, we'll be walking these halls for the last time, counting down the days until graduation, the day that starts the next part of our lives. While we're all anxious to leave these hallways behind and begin to pursue our separate paths in life, it's important to remember all of the steps we've taken in this building, from our initial walk to our lockers during sixth grade orientation, and our steps across the stage at eighth grade graduation, to our first strides as seniors at LMHS, and all the ones in between. This building and the people in it have given us countless memories. In our classrooms, we've learned how to become activists, philosophers, art historians, scientists, mathematicians, and dreamers. We've saved princesses and stopped apocalypses, and spent many hours learning about Elmo and Mount Kilimanjaro, and many less learning about biology. We were the first to witness the mortal side of Mr. Tolan, and most definitely not the last to get a glimpse of immortality in humanities. Not only have our hours spent studying left us with knowledge rivaling that of Dr. Martina, which we can only dream, but we've also acquired skills that will carry over into all aspects of our lives. From discovering how to be our happiest selves, to learning how to visualize our stress and just throw it away, we have our educators and our mentors to thank. They've shaped us into well-rounded young adults, ready for success in the real world. While our high school experience has touched our lives in so many ways, I like to believe that we have left just as great of an impression on LMMHS as it has left on us. In every classroom, there can be found remnants of the class of 2018. From notes and pictures on Mr. Fisher's bulletin board and hand-painted murals in the middle school hallways, to countless championships in the trophy cases and productions in the Duffin Theater. In all these places and more, we have left our permanent mark. Looking ahead, it's the moments where we shared ideas and asked questions, the bonds that we formed as staff and with each other, and the countless memories that we've made that will stay with us forever. Throughout our years here, we have truly become a part of the community that is and forever will be LMMHS. Once we enter into the world, whether it's to attend college or to travel or to join the service or workforce, we'll be required to make life-changing decisions. Hopefully, when those decisions are upon us, the voice that is our little school will have followed us to our corner of the world in order to remind us of our skills and our gifts. To underclassmen, our advice is to enjoy the special time of your lives. Even through Mr. Fisher's notorious tests, Senor Johnson's article presentations, the junior research project, the AP physics exam, and all the other fun assignments that you'll receive. Just sit back, relax, and remember, if every single one of us can do it, so can you. As we approach the final days of our countdown, preparing to take our last steps as high schoolers and the first steps of our next adventure, we'd like to take a moment to look forward. Years from now, the doctors, nurses, engineers, fashion designers, architects, veterinarians, and which other professionals we will have become will still hold a piece of this small town in our hearts. To LMMHS and the Lenox community, we say thank you and farewell.
I just want to take 2 quick seconds to thank some of the biggest forces in our entire class, Ms. Romeo, Ms. Rachowski, our class advisors. The two of them, just the help they've given us is, you can't even measure it. And especially Ms. Romeo came in for our beloved Ms. Pignatelli this year, and she really did a great job stepping up and filling in. And rumor has it that there are flowers under the table, so I'd like to bring them up and give them a round of applause.
Of doing the senior slideshow, mainly Sarah. I'm going to give her most of the credit. But first, I would like to thank you all for sending us pictures and flooding my email and Sarah's email with tons of memories, and it was great to look back and see all of the pictures. So thank you to parents, faculty. You guys really meant a lot.
So get out your tissues, and we now present the Class of 2018 Senior Slideshow.
Okay, so I'd like to take a minute to honor, I'd like to take a minute to honor Mr. Fisher. He is the only teacher retiring this year, but he's really meant a lot to us. So as we welcome Mr. Fisher, I know that I'm supposed to talk about all of the amazing things that he has done, but instead, I would like to take this time to discuss geographic determinism. Geographic determinism affects each and every one of us. Geographic factors, such as rivers, mountains, climate, etc., determine how successful our civilization can be. These geographic factors affect and determine the way in which we live. It affects our culture, our values, beliefs, economy, and everything that encompasses our society. Mr. Fisher has also always emphasized the importance of truly understanding a concept in order to apply it to many different topics. So I've decided to put it to the test. Mr. Fisher is our mountain range. He rocks. He has inspired and pushed us all at a very critical moment in our lives, freshman year. At a time where we are awkward, nervous, and finding our sense of self, he is a substantial role in shaping us into the people we are today. He has the best sense of humor that shines alongside the poorly timed sneezes. He has protected us from the man. He is a teacher that any student feels comfortable discussing their social lives, their hectic home life, or just the stress of the day with. While teaching us world history, he also teaches us important life lessons. He has emphasized that although there may be someone bigger, stronger, smarter, and better looking than you, that you should never stop pursuing what you believe is important. He has pushed us to find our interests in psychology, politics, cultures, economies, and many other topics, while also teaching us to appreciate the value within those things. He has shaped us all in ways that we will never be able to thank him enough for. So Mr. Fisher, wherever you are, as you retire, because George Bush fought the war in Iraq for your right to do so, I would like to thank you on behalf of all of LMMHS, students and faculty alike. We all love and appreciate you, but in a platonic and not creepy kind of way. Thank you, Mr. Fisher.
So team has won their first game of the year. The game took place in pouring rain and hail. The score of this intense match was 4-3. Alec Jordan and Nick Baruch had the goals for the Red Ants. The awesome Lenox goalies, Noah Kalshakogins, Sean Coakley, and Zylian Santos, made many saves.
thought it was real. It was only gym and lunch, we thought it was real. I was even falling math, I ain't even care. Yeah, just to be around you made it worth it. I dropped out, but you still said I'm perfect. I remember at the prom, you was perfect. I remember you were walking on graduation day. I never got the chance to say that. And I remember you were really my friend. And I remember when they all lit the lamp. Now it's crazy how they all know your words.
It feels great, right, feels great, right, yeah.
In that 12 passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older. Couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe.
Wish I didn't drink all of that blast first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would've gotten out of my shell. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought. I felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you and that futon. We just begun. On the grass dreaming, figuring out who I was.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Never thought we'd get old. Maybe we're still young. Maybe you always look back. Think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far, I guess I'm proud. And I ain't worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I felt some pain, I seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
Whoa.
till